Yarn, a pile of blankets, and a bathtub. This is what we can do with it, but let's break it down and see how we did it in the first place. This is White Wall Wednesday, bathroom edition, part one. We are going to do two photo shoots in a bathtub over the next couple weeks, and I want to break down for you how we do it, why we're doing it, and exactly where this leads us. So let me show you the skills that you need to make something like this happen and some of the tips and tricks that I've learned to create really impactful art in your own home. From day one in my artistic journey, I have had very few resources to work with, and that was the inspiration for White Wall Wednesday in general. But specifically today, I want to talk about how we can use everyday objects by using symbolism and connecting those symbols to a larger audience so that our work doesn't have to cost a lot of money to be really impactful. So that's what we're doing today. We're using red yarn, a pile of blankets, but they're going to be hidden, and a bathtub. And the bathtub and the yarn have very interesting associations with them depending on who you are and what your experience is of those things. So we're going to talk about how to use objects and locations symbolically, how to match your pose to the symbolism of the image, and how you can use these same skills to create your own imagery at your own home. If you're excited about this video, let me know. Subscribe, make sure that you press the little bell icon to get notified of new videos. I make them every single week. So let's go into my teensy little bathroom so that I can show you a little bit of what I had to do to make this image. The first way that you can start to innovate is to think symbolically. So look around your house, look at everyday objects, and think about what greater symbol they represent. If you're not super clear on symbolism, watch my video about how symbolism can play a part in your work and how that relates to a larger audience, and that will really help. But come back here, because symbolism is vital to this image and to all of my imagery. So the way that I start to look at symbolism through objects is I find everyday objects and I ask myself what they could represent. So like right now, I'm just looking off camera to a potted plant that is thoroughly dead in my office because I do not know how to take Right now I'm looking off screen and I see a potted plant that is thoroughly dead. And I'm looking at this dead flower. What could a dead flower represent? And essentially, things are ideas, which is a little bit of a heady concept, but things are ideas. That's all it is. We just have ideas of what things are, and so we associate in a universal way things with ideas, and that becomes concrete. So a flower is a sign of life. A dead flower is a sign of death. And we can associate all sorts of different things with that, like maybe flowers dying a month after a funeral, or flowers in your yard that you planted in the spring and that have died in the winter, or maybe it even goes deeper than that for you. So we all have personal associations with different objects, and those objects associate symbols with them, and those symbols have ideas attached to them, and those ideas relate universally to everybody. So think symbolically, look around your house and figure out what you could use. In this case, we used red yarn, and red yarn can be a symbol for lots of different things depending on how it's used. Yarn itself is a type of string or rope, and string or rope or yarn could be used as a symbol of entrapment or being tied up or being tied down or breaking free depending on how you use it. Today it's going to be a symbol of blood. We're going to use tons and tons of red yarn in the bathtub as a symbol of blood. Now, a bathtub and a bathroom in particular is another form of symbolism because it's a location. Locations will always represent ideas and memories and experiences for people. So maybe your idea of a bathtub is a place of relaxation. I'm actually terrified of bathtubs. I look at a bathtub and I immediately think of death. Anybody else? Or is that just me? So that's what I associate with it, and that's how I'm going to use it today. The next thing that we have to do is think simplistically. So many artists are brought down by being too complicated with their art. So if you're not a master of symbolism and how different visual objects work together to tell a story, then it's very likely you could use too many objects as symbols in your work. It's really easy to have contradicting symbols in a piece of artwork where one thing might mean something, but because it's paired with something else, it changes the meaning, and so on and so forth, until there's just kind of a lot of confusion about how that works. And this goes for location mixed with props too. A venue, a wardrobe, a prop, any of those things can contradict one another if they don't all match essentially with the central story that you're trying to tell. Next, we have to think about innovation. artists tell me all the time that they can't make the thing that they want to make because it's just not possible with the resources that they have. And sometimes that's true. There are certain things that we are limited to based on our budget, our location, etc. But most of the time, we can innovate and make something work. So as an example of that, today, I really wanted to fill my bathtub with red yarn. But first of all, I don't have that much red yarn on hand. And second of all, I didn't want to buy that much yarn. It can be kind of pricey, and I don't want to buy enough to fill up my whole bathtub and then some. So instead, I'm taking a bunch of blankets, putting them in the bathtub, and letting that fill up the mass of the tub. And then I'm going to put the yarn on top of that, and it'll look like it's filled with yarn, but it won't be. It is always important to consider the technical aspects of what you're doing. So today we're in a bathroom. It's really, really tiny. I don't have a lot of space in this bathroom. And I have the great fortune of having a window in my bathroom that I can use for light. And it's in a pretty good placement. It's just in front of the bathtub, so I don't have to worry about it being like really from the side or overhead. But I have done tons of shoots in bathtubs before. I'll show you them here, and they are so much fun to do, and for all of them I have only used whatever light was available in the bathroom, like the overhead light or the vanity mirror sink light, and they work out great. The awesome thing about just using whatever you have is that you learn to work with it, whatever that may be. If you have external lights that you can pop in there, great, but if you don't, go for it anyway and just see what you can do with the lighting in your bathroom. So I have used these really, really yellow, orange, fluorescent lights in my bathroom. I actually really like it. It can fit into my aesthetic quite well. You can always desaturate, change the color temperature, etc., in your camera or in Photoshop. So use what you have. Of course, really use what you have. If you have lights that you want to use, go for it. If not, do whatever you can. Another technical glitch that we could have is that the bathtub is bright white, and I am not bright white, and the yarn will be red, and it'll be some darkness further back in the tub. So the brightest thing in this image, no matter what, is going to be the edge of the bathtub that gets into our frame. And that's something that I'm not actually going to worry about too much. The reason is that I have a couple of things that I can do. One, I can take my image in camera raw into Photoshop, and I can use that raw editing to take down the highlights on the tub. The next thing that I can do, if I don't have that sort of availability in RAW, I can still take that image in, whether it's RAW or JPEG, into Photoshop and manually darken it using the burn tool, or selecting it and darkening it through curves or levels or exposure or something like that. You can also use texture to overlay there to try to just dull it down a little bit, and all of those things can be really effective. So no matter where you're shooting, if you have little bits of inconsistency with your vision, ask yourself down the line, is this fixable? And if it is, fix it. If it's not, then try to figure out a way to fix it in camera. So one way might be to drape a sheet over the bathtub so that it looks like it's a different color altogether, or just mask the space entirely. It doesn't even have to be a bathtub if you drape it with enough fabric. Pose matters a lot, of course. That's a super obvious thing to say, but I don't know how often we really think about it. So depending on my pose, whether it's really hunched over and sad, or really bright and a little bit more hopeful, my pose is going to tell you the story of the image. So it's one thing to use symbolism through the yarn and the location and stuff like that. It is another thing entirely to be able to interact with that symbolism so that you understand the story I intend you to understand. The way that I pose in this image will make the blood seem really dark or really hopeful or something in between, and that's up to me. So posing is vital. Because I am in such a small space, I'm going to have to utilize a wide-angle lens in this area, but if you don't have a wide-angle lens, you can use something probably as tight as a 50 and then just stitch the images together later, which is great because it'll provide a bigger frame, a bigger canvas, so you can print larger. It's also good if you want to get a greater depth of field in your shot, because you'll be shooting closer to the subject, the background will be blurrier, and therefore you will be able to create sort of a blurrier background, more separation. But I'll probably go with the easiest thing to do, which is to use a wider angle lens here. What would you shoot in your tub, or what will you shoot in your bathtub? I can't wait to see. And like I said, we are going to do another White Wall Wednesday video in my bathtub, this time using water, and we're gonna turn it into an ocean. I hope that this was really helpful for you and that you picked up some tips that help you in your own craft. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe. And after you subscribe, make sure that you press the bell icon so that you get notified every time I post a new video. I share at least 1 to 2 videos every single week. I have tons of content out there and I love, 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 and I'm so grateful that you support me in this. Thank you so much and happy White Wall Wednesday.